I'm with Dr. Karla Jenkins from the University of Nebraska. She is a range management cow-calf field specialist, and we're going to visit a little bit about one of the topics she talked about today, using crop residues and byproducts to limit feed cows in confinement.
As grass gets more expensive because it's in shorter supply, I believe we're going to have a mindset shift on what's the most economical place to maintain a cow, and it may not be grass. We may want to use our grass resources for calves that can put on a lot of gain and that we can then sell and get some return off of that. The more economical way to maintain a cow may be at least part of the year on residues and byproducts, and that may be in partial confinement. When we limit feed cows in confinement, what we're trying to do is feed them a high energy dense diet and limit the actual amount of dry matter that they consume to reduce the cost of the daily feed ration, but having the energy in it high enough that it meets the needs of the cow and she maintains her weight. So as opposed to a feedlot setting where we're trying to get those cattle to put on weight and gain and get them finished out and harvest those animals, this cow, we just want to maintain her. So we don't want her over fat because that's expensive. We don't want her very thin because then she may not rebreed. But we want to try to maintain her in a moderate condition score, maybe about a 5. When we put cattle in confinement and we're used to feeding cattle in a feedlot, our mindset is that the bunk needs to always be full and the cattle need to be getting fat, and that's going to have to shift a little bit. We always want to feed the best quality feeds in a feedlot. That's kind of our mindset for the feedlot. We want the silages and the grains and the very, you know, we want to push these cattle to finish out, and that's going to have to change a little bit. We can feed residues and mix them with a high energy byproduct or something and limit these cows and not have them gaining weight and have a slick bunk most of the day, and the cow will be okay. There have been many feeding trials that we've done at various universities where we've really gotten a pretty good handle on what the energy value of certain byproducts are. And we need to use those values in our equations when we're balancing rations. If we underestimate that value, then we're going to overfeed it, and that's going to be expensive. We overestimate it and we don't feed enough, then we could end up with open cows. Then the other thing is we have to keep in mind the nutrient requirement of the cow in each segment of her production cycle. And if that calf stays by her side in confinement for very long, he's going to begin to eat. That a nursing calf's eating 1% of his body weight in forages by the time he's 2 to 3 months old. We need to start figuring that 1% of his body weight into the amount of feed that we're putting in the bunk. Many of our states have quite a few crop residue acres that don't get utilized. We need to increase utilization on those. It may be that those pairs can go out and graze some of those after harvest. Then maybe we do some sort of early weaning where then we take those calves onto the higher quality pastures that we were talking about, and we put that cow with her low requirements, now that lactation's been removed, may we put her back in confinement and feed her some other residues and just, you know, a little bit of byproduct to increase that just enough to meet her needs.